flash makes them.
Shuffling.
guarda.
E gli prese a te dai bei colli da me.
Ma guarda, che roba io mi ha, dai.
Thank you. Thank you. almost 180 years later, we find we are dealing with the same scenario again. A family been forced from their home with nowhere to go due to circumstances that others created. The force of greed that forces the eviction hired help to carry out this callous action. The similarities between the two scenes may be centuries apart, but the stakeholders are slightly
dissimilar.
This is sad to think that the terrible things that happened centuries ago, first of all, would never be allowed to happen again, like before us then together. How is it all going to happen to this? I should be able to do it, send the law to the other powers of the country.
Who do you affect?
Thank you.
is outing, the smaller animals get more killer. The more things change, the more things stay the same. And we learn nothing from it.
Everybody, I forgot to shut this off. I think for breakfast I'll have tomato rosemary soup. Okay. So yeah, I forgot a few more other things in there. Yeah, I'm hungry. Remind you. Looks like this with noodles, seasoning in there, and I'll have my crackers in there. You silly pig. Here. Here. Hi, mommy.
After Heather says Marissa's bad behavior, as escalated, Heather says, the recently discovered that you have a secret.
The phone, why they gave it to her, or who's paying for it. When I found the phone, I told her she had two choices. She could either just give the phone to me easily, or send her stuff. She told me that the phone was at home, but when I got home, of course...
...radio stations, full blast at the same time. And... nothing is being exchanged. And that just has to stop. And you know, what I've got to say to you, Marissa, is what in corporate America is referred to as upstream management. You know, you're the child, she's the parent. You have to have emotional integrity and say what you do and mean what you say. And sometimes you have to manage the boss. I get managed all the time around here, I guarantee you. You gotta know.
San Diego, California. We will call this young woman Patricia. When she was 9 years old, Patricia went to a clinic complaining of food shortages.
You know what? If you just take a seat, it'll just be a few minutes.
Patricia had no way of knowing that she was about to see her, had recently been forced to resign from another clinic. 4 different complaints of sexual misconduct had been filed against them. By a young woman in her 20s. The doctor's name was Armstrong, but traveling where? His family could only guess until they received a notice from a car impound yard in Georgia. The Molnars learned that 6 days after Tim left home, his car was found abandoned in a parking lot just a block from the Atlanta bus terminal.
When we went to inspect the car, we did find his driver's license and wallet and some identification in our credit card, which indicated to me that he changed his identity. In other words, he wanted to start a new life.
Oh. Yeah. take some time, unwind, unravel your mind, and walk the labyrinth through till it brings it back to you. Take some time, unwind, unravel your mind, and walk the labyrinth through till it brings it back to you. I'm good looking for some change, but like a desert holds the rain. Thank you. darkness, my friend. I've come to talk with you again. In the vision, slowly creeping, left its seeds while I was sleeping. And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. And restless dreams are what to come. Narrow streets and cobblestone. Neath the halo of a street lamp, I turn my collar to the cold and damp. When my eyes were stopped by the flash of a neon light, split the night and touch the sound of silence. And then they can cut a song. 10,000 people being bored. People talking without speaking. People hearing without listening. People writing songs that voices never share. No one dare disturb a sound of silence. Fools that I do not know. Silence like a cancer grows. Hear my words and my heat teach you. Take my arms and my heat reach you. But my words like silent raindrops fell. And a cold in the wind of silence. To the neon coming here, and the sign flashed out its warning. In no words it was forming, and the sign said the words of the prophets are written on the subway walls, in tenement halls, and whispered in the sound of silence. Go somewhere new, I go to the place. to find our way out. And I go to the woods to feel better. And I go to the river to let my mind run. And I go to the mountain to gain perspective. And I go to the fields to open hope. I look to the lake to reflect. I look to the sky to imagine. I travel highways to go somewhere new. I go to the world.
rests in a pool of stars tonight.
I believe in love.
pretty.
Good boy.
Kimba. Good boy. I like tabby cats. He's so cute.
I love his. I call it his round cherub face and big green eyes.
The M mark on their forehead means they're blessed by the Virgin Mary.
Oh, that's nice. That's a good way to think of it.
Yeah. Poor cookie.
All right, you need to sit back. We're gonna numb and
stitch
to these cuts, okay?
Ma'am, you remember what happened to you?
I was in the lobby. I was
leaving. What time is it?
4:45.
On the first floor.
I have to go home. My husband travels. I should
all
be there.
All right, just calm down, Marilyn.
Your apartment building was very badly damaged during the fire.
That's not where I live.
It's okay to cry, Megan.
First and second degree, nothing circumferential. X-ray 2 to 4 of MS. We'll debride after that.
So you're home by yourself, huh?
I was hoping you can help us understand why he likes to attack us in the evenings, and sometimes he gets wound up.
So the fact that it happens at a predictable time is actually good news, because that tells us that as your family starts to have one of those energetic spikes, even if you're watching TV or whatever, and oh, time to go to bed, and everybody gets up to go to bed, that's an energetic spike, and that could be what Tucker is responding to. The next thing that we want to do is start engaging what I call the 3 R's, and that's routine, ritual, rhythm, that we're always trying to get our cat's natural rhythms in line with ours. Our circadian rhythms are somewhat the same.
I think I'm gonna take a shower right now, guys. I just can't stand myself here. Plus, I'm starting to feel a little tired. Fucking gonna lie. So. Okay, see you later.
I'm not sure how to do that. This is my first delivery, and I'm like, I said, well, I'll break it, and then, you know, we'll just go on and let you deliver. Every time I would go out the door, I would hear several voices. Santa Claus, what you doing? Santa Claus, come over here. And I felt a little bad that I couldn't stop, but of course, you know, there were more important things going on at the time.
She is blindsided with violent cramps.
Nicole actually said that our water broke.
I felt extreme contraction pains. I had to call 911.
By the time Nicole gets to the hospital, she is already too dilated for an epidural.
Before I even got to the labor and delivery room, they already had me pushing.
You're gonna have this baby now. You need to start pushing. You need to get her to delivery.
Give her a moment. Okay, here we go.
All right, I'm going to go in now. Sorry, I was busy with something on my phone, downloading Shaylee's videos and naming them and all that stuff. So I'm going to get washed up. I can't stand myself right now. So, all righty. I know I should shave my legs too and stuff. Ooh, they're really hairy.
Alright.
Just stepped out, guys. So, strange, now I'm feeling a little hungry. I think I'll find something to eat, maybe, I don't know what. Maybe macaroni and cheese again, and whatever I don't plan to eat, so I'll put it away in a Tupperware thing. I do look a little tired. I don't understand, no matter how long I sleep for, it's like, I woke up feeling fine, and then I'm like, crashing at this hour. I don't know if it's the weather, because it's Eeyore kind of weather, and yes, I went out in this, it was only misting like, hardly any rain, but wetness, you know. I had droplets on my glasses when I walked back home. So yeah, I spent about $9 today. I got that dumpling soup I was eating, the chicken dumpling, and a brownie battered coffee. And so, excuse me. So I am gonna dry up, get in my night clothes, probably take a nap after when I'm done eating something, and then probably if I wake up later to go pee, I could do some homework, like that worksheet, like another worksheet, and then when I'm done with that worksheet, I'll go back to sleep. I hope you know what I'm talking about. Yeah. But I'll just play tonight by ear, you know. So. So, yeah. Okay. How come today felt like a Saturday? I'm like, what in the fuck? What day is it? And I'm like, I look down there, I'm like, oh, Sunday. Okay. Confusion. Not confused anymore. But yeah, it felt like a Saturday to me all day. And then I'm like, oh yeah, today is Sunday. And I circled Sunday on my calendar thing on my diary like I always do. So why am I confused as to why it's like feeling like a Saturday? Just days have been going by so fucking fast. Like, holy shit, it's like 6:14 already. Jeez Louise. Plus I, where is my, oh, 28% is my battery. I get better charge my phone up after when I'm done drying off. So, all right.
Step in as a legal guardian. Otherwise, she'd be in court and it could be a three-ring circus. The other thing that I'd want to see you all do is, to the extent that, Beth, you have the kids for extended blocks of time, Carrie and Steve should each execute what's called designation of standby guardian. It's a downloadable form. You don't have to pay an attorney to do it. But this way, Beth, if there's a medical emergency, you're legally empowered to deal with it.
Yeah, the last thing we want to do right now
I mean, everything's about timing, right? And the last thing you want to do right now is make funds available.
Yeah, you guys. I'm going to do my ID now and just go to sleep for a little bit. I don't know how long, but, yeah. I am tired, so once I wake up and feel refreshed, I'll, play bingo, and, what the fuck? And, I will, take my pills and go back to sleep, and I guess when I wake up again, I will, be more refreshed, and then I'll work on my stuff. When I wake up, I'll play bingo, brush my teeth, take my pills, go back to sleep. Yeah. So this means, if my recorder app doesn't record well, good night now. So yeah. Just feeling so fucking tired that I saw something gray on my eyelash again. Wait, I don't know. I'm just weird right now. Maybe it's from waking up at like 4:15 to pee and then I went back to sleep and I don't know what the fuck. Again, mommy, you know the rules. No banging things, like making noise and no touching things. You can touch the baby kitty, Pat Pat. She's always going to be my baby to me. My little baby girl. Just like how I'm going to be your baby girl. So, was that like a wrinkle right there or right there, like on it? I don't know. But yeah. Alright, so you might hear me snoring. Alrighty. No time lapse. I just don't feel like doing it. Good night. Yep, I'm donkey awake, guys. I don't know if I want to go back to sleep or maybe I'll play a couple of games. Brush my teeth, take my pills, go poopy if I need to, and I feel like I gotta poop. I don't know. Sorry about the too much information. And just to wake up early too. Do some assignments. I don't know. I have one more. Donkeys. Yeah, you. I am gonna try to poop now, so. And I found some Irish land videos. Ireland, excuse me. So, I'll download one now while I'm pooping, and yeah.
G60 O66 G50 N38 N43 O68 Round over. Now let's keep going.
So I played my game of bingo. I showed you another clip from Ireland. And I'm gonna look around on YouTube. And listen to narrations and probably a few Dr. Phil episodes or something. I don't know. Whatever. So, okie dokie. All right.
There was a little bit of a lightning storm in the area, a little rain. It was getting dark, so the first thing I did was I took a spotlight back into the backyard. Couldn't get the truck to it. It was something I'd have to climb. I put my climbing equipment on. We have to wear strap spikes to each leg, and you wear a belt with a strap. It appeared that one of the wires was actually touching the pole and thereby blew the fuse in the fuse holder.
Ron, so I climbed. Looking at me and saying, "We're gonna be okay, babe. We're gonna be okay." That's what got us through. That's what got me through. I survived because Ron was there. If my husband hadn't been there, I wouldn't have made it. And probably my mom wouldn't have made it. That's it.
However, stress due to CA and neglect can significantly reduce the size of the child's thymus. In fact, one autopsy of an 8-year-old child who was tortured by his family for several years found the boy's thymus weighed about 10 grams. It should be noted that a normal 8-year-old boy should have a thymus gland weighing about 100 grams.